Today, I had a really interesting email come in. The email basically said that this couple was intending to build a cottage of their dreams on a waterfront lot in a certain area of the island. As soon as they told me what area of the island it was, bells and whistles went off because I realized that they're building on what could be the highest erosion rate part of the island that exists. So basically, I brought up the map of the lot. It was a little tiny quarter acre or third acre lot. And I looked at some studies, and I'm suggesting that maybe they reconsider building their cottage because it's not going to be very long before that lot may disintegrate based on historical data. What I'm trying to provide here is a level of caution before you build or before you buy a waterfront lot, specifically a lot that was probably subdivided prior to around 2006. Back in the 60s and 70s and 50s, in order to subdivide property, you'd basically draw it out in a napkin, pass it into the government, and in all likelihood, you'd get approval. Today, the process is a lot different. So getting back to the cottage build or buying waterfront property, one thing you may want to do is order a PEI coastal report for your specific property ID number, PID number. As of this video, I believe the service is free and the government will tell you what you should be expecting in that particular piece of property. Alternatively, you can Google Prince Edward Island Coastal Erosion Report, and that will give you a rather long PDF document that will contain a map that will show you a color-coded reference as to what parts of the island are eroding quicker. In closing, the good news is, since about 2006, the provincial government released new rules that required the erosion studies to be implemented into the subdivision of the property, and they require now a buffer. This buffer is typically 60 times the yearly rate of erosion times 2. So this should give you at least 60 years of use on that property before you get really, really close to the edge. So that's it for today. If you have any questions about this topic, PEI real estate, or PEI in general, put them in the comments below just after you subscribe to the channel and give me a thumbs up. Have a great day. Thanks for watching.